I think it's all part of playing the All Blacks, and everyone's grown up. I was no different watching like the Wallabies play the All Blacks. You knew there was going to be the Haka, and then it's just gone. It's grown even more and more into I think a great sort of ceremony, and again, it's very respectful of what it means to New Zealand and obviously to the All Blacks. And but at the same time, you know, it's a great chance for you to get close to your mate in the Wallaby jersey and think about how you want to start the game against these men who are issuing you a challenge, and you take up the challenge of playing. And it's just a great contest, and it's the beginning of what's a fantastic contest.
I think it was my third Test match in Sydney. And facing up to it, yeah, it is quite intimidating, and particularly your first. But you know that you're standing up to it next to your mates, and most of them had been there before. And for me, that was significant because you're standing beside someone who you knew was going to be beside you during that game.
I guess approaching the Haka for me is pretty basic. I think I'm more focusing on my first involvement once kickoff. Obviously, I like to absorb a little bit of the energy of the atmosphere and respect the Haka, but I don't really get too carried away with what's going on. It's more the thoughts and the preparation of post kickoff.
Yeah, it's pretty emotionally charged, and you feed off that. It's imposing, but at the same time, it's something that can really fire you up and, you know, really sort of get the hairs on the back of your neck firing, and it's good for us. We enjoy it, we respect it, but we also enjoy being able to go into that very next, the kickoff after such an emotionally charged sort of start to the game.
I remember it went into blur. I remember the guys telling me pretty much what we said earlier about what it is when you play the All Blacks, how fast and furious it is. I guess the intensity of how it starts. Everything is just done that much faster. You don't have as much time to do things, so you're really working off instinct quite a lot, and that was definitely my case. Well, I think we scored within about the first 30 seconds of the game. I think Jason Little caught a high ball off David Knox and we're away, and that was probably the start of what was just an amazing first test for me against the All Blacks in terms of intensity and how it's just relentless. It goes for 80 minutes and they just don't give up. That they will play at that level and attempt to play at that level for 80 minutes. So yeah, that was my first experience, and I loved every minute of it.
It was just a step up from what we had experienced up until that point, and I just remember the scrums, the rolling mauls, it was all just that, the intensity, the pace of it was a greater challenge. And really, as I just turned 21, very young in the team, you're just running around trying to go as hard as you can so you weren't made to look stupid. And that was my main goal that day, not to look stupid. And we ended up winning that day. I remember Rob Edgerton took a high ball, the high ball hit the ground, and he jumped on top of John Kerwin to get it and sprint to the line, and that really was the try that sealed it for us.
That was my first ever run-on game. I was pretty young playing at fullback, and I just remember going into the game, and Tana Umanga was the captain of the All Blacks, and he was suggesting in the media that they were going to maybe target me somewhat, and then I made the silly mistake of catching eye contact with him in the Haka. So I felt as though if I looked away, he kind of got the better of me, so I kind of looked at him, but I was also not wanting to think I was staring him down, so I was in a bit of an awkward situation. But I was pretty lucky to get a pretty good early touch and scored a try, and end up going back to halfway and I think throwing up all my nerves. But from that point on, I was pretty comfortable and just excited to be out there.